tilling around. It's just me and Grandpa waiting on a familiar sound. Come 11:30, we both hear Grandma's voice saying it's time to eat, you better bring it in, boys. Well, the food's out on the table and I's ready to take my place. She pulled me aside once while Grandpa was washing his face. Said, you won't need this now, boy, oh, but someday you will. She said, keep this in your shoe, it was a $20 bill. I was up there in Chicago, you know, just killing my time. Yeah, the show got over early, so I was just blowing my mind. This man came up to me and he tried to ruin all my fun. He pushed me to the ground and then he pulled out a gun. Said, if you've no money, boy, this'll be the end of you. I said, hold on a minute, I got a 20 in my shoe. He leaned in there real close and then he stared in disbelief. When I reached for that 20, you know I sized up that thief. Oh, I took that man's life. Cause next to Grandma's 20, I keep Grandpa's knife. So Grandma and Grandpa, they don't. Your knife and 20 in my shoe. Thank y'all so much. It's been an honor for the last 10 years to play for you. I'm working on it. I'm working on it. take a little while. I'm working on it. I'm working on it. I'm hoping that it sticks. Might not be the perfect fix, but I'm working on it. Trying to walk in other shoes. I try to listen to their views, but when I see them on the news and the language that they use, well, I think they're all confused. I'm trying hard not to swear. I try to trade it in for prayers, but when there's trouble everywhere, it's too much to hardly bear. Doesn't anybody care? I'm working on it. Tonight, I come to you this year, friends, with a confession. I am addicted to music festivals. I love them. I don't care if they're big or if they're small, if they're inside, if they're in February or if they're in September. I love music festivals. My very first music festival was called Summer Camp Music Festival in Chillicothe, Illinois. There were 20,000 people there. I wasn't on the lineup, I just played outside in my tent and by my car. But it was a pretty special experience. And I realized that the only people that were having there more fun than me and my friends were the people on stage. So I decided the next year, I'm getting my ass on that damn festival, I'll tell you what. So I went home and I practiced and I practiced, and I came back the next year and they said, all right, you can play. And they put me on this slab of concrete and they gave me 4 PBRs. And I was like, all right. And I was like, thank you so much. Next year I'm gonna get a 6-pack. And I went home and I practiced and I practiced and I wrote a bunch more songs. And then next year I came back and they said, this time we're putting you on a real stage and we're giving you 6 PBRs. And I said, hell yeah. And I said, could you do one thing for me though? Could you please put my name on the poster? Because at the time, I needed to prove where I was on the weekends. I said, it could really help me if you put me on the poster. And they said, okay, we'll put you on the poster. And I was like, all right. I went home and I wrote a bunch more songs and I kept practicing and practicing. The next year I came back, I got a 12-pack of PBR and they told me that I was gonna be on the poster. Except when I showed up, I didn't see my name. I said, I really need to prove where I am. And they said, well, you're down there in the bottom. I said, where? I said, that spot where it says, and many, many more. I said, that's not helping my cause. So I kept practicing and I kept practicing, and ladies and gentlemen, I've been practicing for the last 20 years. If you happen to heard the story earlier. And now, friends, I'm here to tell you, you can generally find Chicago Farmer at a Midwest music festival on the poster with a 12-pack to a case of PBR beers, and you can generally find myself and my name somewhere towards the middle to the upper region of the music festival poster. And the really, really good festivals like Whispering Beard, I'm pretty close to the top. What do y'all think about that? And headline the whole thing. I mean, it might take another 10 years, but hell, as you may have heard, I'm working on it. I'm working on it. I'm hoping that it sticks. Might not be the perfect fix, but I'm working on it. I'm working on it. Fix, we're all just working on it. Thank you very much. We got the merch table over there. I just want to let you know, on the way to the merch table, there's gonna be a long line that's gonna seem like it's not going anywhere. You guys know what to do. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, my friend and yours, Chicago Farmer.